Warm welcome from me, of course, as well. It's always hard representing Speedmaster Heavy Metal and cannot be on the machine, showing the machines running. That's always more impressive and, of course, exciting. But I do my very best to bring the excitement that we all feel with our Drupa generation across via digital media to you, to your home, in front of your screens now. But let me start with our slogan, Unfold Your Potential. Why are we talking about Unfold Your Potential? Because there is potential. And we will talk in the future, and a lot of the Heidelbergers you maybe meet will talk a lot about that yellow bar. And this yellow bar, what it is all about, I would like to explain so that you are up to date when the Heidelbergers come and ask you about your opinion of this yellow bar. So what is it all about? First of all, we are focusing on the Heidelberg user experience. Unfold your employees' potential is one of the important messages we need to get across, because, as already mentioned earlier, people, getting skilled people is one key. And on the other hand, having an attractive and modern environment to get those people attracted to the printing industry and to your print shop is important for you. As well, push to stop the next generation is there, and that is, of course, to unfold the potential of your machinery. And the question is, is there potential? And measuring of potential here is done with the OEE. We introduced that 4 years back, that kind of slide. The OEE gives us a good idea where we are, where we want to be, and we can measure. And what you can measure, you can improve. 100% OEE is not realistic, so therefore we said, okay, we have to deduct a certain speed part, so we cannot run a full speed with all kind of jobs. We have to deduct maintenance and uptime. If we then deduct 2 minutes per job as make ready, we see that we have left this blue area, which we see as the area of realistic performance. And if we then look where our customers are producing worldwide, we have over 10,000 machines online where we get data and can find out where they are. We can see that they are in the 20% area. So there's a lot of room for improvement, and some customers already are utilizing this. They are in the area of 50% OEE, and they are doing things different to the others, and we wanted to find out what that might is. Therefore, we did a thorough analysis on the example of the Speedmaster XL106, and the average Speedmaster XL106 has an average OEE of 27% at a run length of 4,600 sheets per job. Well, that means, on the other hand, that there is 73% opportunity or potential. Yeah? And here we are talking about potential, unfold your potential. You remember our motto for Drupa. And that is, of course, something we need to address. Half of this is mechanical and technical related time losses which we have. Yeah? So, for example, for wash-up times, plate changing times, maintenance which we have to do to keep the machine up and running, things like this. So we can improve this, of course. And the other half is people and process related. Yeah? And here, now for the first time, you see this ominous yellow bar. Yeah? And that is one of the parts where we want to work on. And I explain why that is so important. If we start to improve the gray bar, so the technical things, that's what we did over 15, 20 years now, and we really made a big progresses there, we find out that this has only an indirect impact on the OEE. So in the first place, if we do improvements in the gray bar gets smaller, but at the same time, the yellow bar gets bigger. The OEE only rises if we at the same time manage to improve as well the yellow bar. We learned that, as I mentioned, we had a lot of improvements, simultaneous make ready, even speed increases, a lot of things we introduced the last years. And we see the result only partly taking effect in practice. So in theory, the machines should be more productive than they are. So that means we do not get it on the road. And therefore, we then thought about what happens if we do the other way around, if we work on the yellow bar directly. And the interesting thing is, even if you do not change technology, the yellow bar has a direct impact on the OEE. So if we have improvements on the yellow bar, we have lifted the OEE directly. And talking about doubling the OEE, that was our prediction 4 years back, that the industry will doubling their entire productivity in the next 10 years to come. That would mean we cannot achieve that only by reducing the gray bar. We need definitely to address the yellow bar, and we even have to focus on that because this is the bigger potential that is addressable. With push to stop, we have the key element to get that done. Push to stop is the key to minimize the yellow bar. And with our Drupa 2020 generation, which we are really proud of, the most intelligent and the most automated Speedmaster we ever had, we had a clear focus on operator-independent performance. We closed automation gaps, we developed intelligent assistants, we will have even more now. We have digital press process integration, not just since yesterday, we've been working on that for long years and getting better and better. We have the possibility to utilize digital data to make fact-based decisions for improvements. We utilize the potential of artificial intelligence, a very, very powerful weapon we have for future developments. And we have first products up and running for Drupa now. But let me step a little back and step to the automotive area, because we have some simultaneous things here. When we talk about user experience in a car yesterday, some years back, it looked similar to this, what we see here. I think most of us know these times very well. And if we look into that today, the user experience today we have heads-up display, voice recognition, remote parking assists, a lot of things around. And that makes a completely different user experience. And only if you then drive a car which does not have this kind of features, you really miss it. You wonder how you can drive without that features. Same comes true for navigation. Navigation yesterday. Today we all have integrated navigation systems with real-time navigation. Even if you have connected it to your Outlook calendar, you sit in your car and the car already knows where you want to go because it's in your calendar. Things like that are happening today. Same thing with headlights. In the past, you had manual on-off. You had the high beam as well, switched on, switched off. If you forgot it, you got a nice blinking from the guy who's coming against you. Today, this is done all automatically. I do not even know where I switch on the light on my car. We have LED beam going 600 meters wide. We have a high and low beam automatically switched on, switched off. So that's the user experience. And it comes through for presses as well. That's how it all started some years ago. All manual, great quality, great value. But what we see today as a Speedmaster is completely different. It's a smart piece of equipment, a smart press, modern, integrated, attractive, and working in a digital environment, communicating with other intelligent devices in an intelligent managed print shop. The priorities have changed over time, in automotive, but as well in the printing area. When we start talking about automation, automotive. In the past, we talked about what's the maximum speed of the car, what's the number of cylinders, what's the acceleration, what's the cylinder capacity, things like this. Today, different user experience, digital integration, internet services, passenger safety, all that kind of things are becoming more important. Even ecological aspects are more and more important. Similar with presses, and I'm a tech guy as well. Yeah? So in the past, when I started with Heidelberg, it was all about technology. Speed, of course, yeah, when we introduced the XL105 at that time, 18,000 was the thing. But features as well. And we optimized single processes, and we talked about that, and it was important and was good. But today, things change. We talk about OEE, we talk about net output. What is the machine, the investment delivering over a day, a week, a year, over the entire time of usage? That is what comes more and more into the discussions. We reduce touch points. We are doing preventive service concepts. We are talking about a smart print shop. Even we talk about a smart industry. That's the next step. How do we interact with each other? And how do we utilize the possibility that we have intelligent products? And Heidelberg is one of the drivers here, and in the printing industry, the driver of this integration and of this intelligent way of networking products in a smart print shop. And therefore, we are very proud to introduce the Heidelberg user experience for the most intelligent and automated Speedmaster we ever had. We have extended our range of digital assistant systems, and we have as well extended our IntelliFamily, family, IntelliStart and IntelliGuide we introduced earlier, but we have new kids on the block at IntelliRun and IntelliLine, which I will introduce in a few minutes. This comes true not only for the XL machines. It is very important that we have push-to-stop Prinect cloud integration for the entire product portfolio for all Speedmasters available and for all machines who have an automated plate loading system and an inline measuring device. We even have autonomous capabilities. So push-to-stop for any Speedmaster as of Drupa 2020. New is IntelliStart 3, the third generation of our patented intelligent job-changing software, which navigates the operator and, whenever possible, does autonomous processes. Whenever we have to wait for the push of the button that the operator starts something, we are losing time. That's what you find in the yellow bar. We have a functionality called autofill, where we can directly, from the scheduler, shoot the jobs into the wall screen's job queue. No interference, no touch point anymore. We can set up the inspection control, which is quite cumbersome if you have to do that manually. We have the data available with the job ticket. There's nothing to do, no touch point anymore. New plate management integration. Plate management, if you do a lot of short runs, it's really important that you manage your plates. Where are they? Are they in the right sequence? Which trolley? Where do I find them? And so on. We have implemented that into IntelliStart as well. And many other things. But now, the next big thing which we have is IntelliRun. IntelliRun is not only navigating as IntelliStart through the make-ready. IntelliRun is taking care for the entire production process. So we have continuous navigation, we have the right information at the right time. You can compare it to your navigation system in the car. When you're traveling on the highway and you have an exit ahead, you get just at the right moment detailed information about the situation on the exit. 30 minutes earlier, that is not really interesting for you, but just in the moment when you exit, you need this information. Is there a roundabout? Which line do I use? You get a picture that shows you exactly what to do. And that's the idea, basically, of IntelliRun. How does that look like? Here a little bit more in detail. You see in the lower bar, the dark gray bar, you see the job sequence, which we have in our press center. Job 0 is just printed. And you see now that IntelliRun is taking care of all the jobs which we have in this job queue. IntelliStart is taking care of the make ready. That are the green areas on the machine line. The blue areas is when the machine is printing. So there are some manual tasks to do that are the yellow parts for the operator. And during make ready, IntelliStart is navigating the operator to do so. At the right time, you have to fill in ink and things like that. But we have a lot of things which the operator could do while the machine is printing in order to avoid waiting times and extending the make ready. Think about the yellow bar. This is exactly the yellow bar. So for example, providing the plates for the next job should be done while the current job is running. Yeah, sounds simple, yeah, but sometimes you forget it. IntelliRun tells you whatever 200 sheets before the job is printed, you should have prepared plates. Please do it right now. Yeah, things like that are going to be implemented, and we have already a long wish list of our beta customers who want to accomplish a lot of other tasks for the operator, which we can include here. Now you wonder, why are we having that all on the wall screen? How does my operator or my helper know that? When do I need to do something in the printing unit? And therefore, we extend the navigation to the printing units directly as well. So that's called IntelliLine. We will have an LED bar on each printing unit. That's the blue line you can see here on the picture. And this indicates what is the status of the machine. When you're printing, all units are blue. So whenever you come into your print shop and see a blue machine, everything is fine, you make money. When the machine is yellow, the units are yellow, the operator has to do something manually. So that are the areas where he has to do something. Even just imagine the machine is blue and in one unit it's getting yellow. That means there's something to do, maybe ink cartridge to change, things like that. If you're around the machine and you see one unit is turning yellow, you know exactly, I have to look, something needs to be done here. If the machine is green, that means that there is automatic make-ready processes ongoing. So IntelliStart is leading this process currently. Don't interrupt. Everything is fine. It's done in the most efficient and fastest way possible. But there are other assistants, new things, which are in the area of artificial intelligence. For example, the new wash assistant. We did further investigations and we found out that there is a lot of potential in wash-ups. Wash-ups are required. We need to do it, but we have to optimize it. There's a lot of potential here as well. We have three wash-up programs, a quick one, a standard one, and an intensive one. And wonder which one is most often chosen. It's the intensive one. For good reasons, because the operator wants to be on the safe side when he is choosing his wash-up program. If he is doing too short, maybe he has problems with the following job, and therefore the most used program is the intensive program. That means that you use more wash-up solvent, that you use more wash-up cloth, and you're losing time. So we analyzed that, and with the wash assist, we have a software that calculates, based on the data, which we have, how much sheets were printed, how much ink coverage, what kind of material, and taking all the information we have and giving a recommendation for the wash program to be chosen. We calculated what the potential is about that, and in a for blanket and impression cylinder wash-up, we could go up to 80 hours per year in a three-shift operation, plus 20% solvent and cloth, which we could save. for packaging running 24/7, we think that we even can go to 125 hours time saving per year. The next artificial intelligence feature that we have is the new powder assistant. We have to live with powder for some applications, and we have a similar situation here. The operator wants to be on the safe side, and that means he has a certain level of powder where he has good experience with, and he is using the same level of powder for a lot of applications, even if he has no low ink coverage. The chart here shows that very dramatic. The blue one is the data we collected at a customer, and we found out that exactly that happens. At low coverage, we have the same amount of powder than on high coverage. Now the powder assist as well takes the data we have, the ink coverage. We know if we have a perfecting machine how the inks come together in the pile, and we can calculate. We know the ink, we know the substrate, we know the ink coverage, and out of that we can calculate what would be the correct amount of powder. We did that at our beta test, and after 2 weeks already, the customer insisted that we have that not only on this machine, but on his three other machines as well. The new Press Center XL is coming. It's our modern and intuitive press operation. As you know it over years now, always front-running technology, now new with LED illumination, with gesture control, multi-touch screen, and with Speedmaster operating system. But to give you a little idea on real machine feeling, we provided a short video, and my colleague Jürgen Mittmann will explain you now on the machine directly what the innovations are here.
Hello, I'd like to give you a short overview about the new Speedmaster operating system on this new 24-inch multi-touch screen. The first view is a job view. Here you see all the data we get out of the Prinect workflow. If you want to go in details, here you see every job in detail, the thumbnails, for example, the job number, everything in detail. But the very nice, beautiful thing is we have now on every machine IntelliStart 3 included. Here you have the job list where you can prepare jobs in front up or during the production is running. And we have here the process view. On top, a new function we have now in IntelliStart 3 is a change overview. Here the operator see what must be changed and what is will be stand for the next job. Also complete new on the Speedmaster operating system is this menu, navigated, because here, for example, the next function is register. Next function, inking and dampening adjustments. And the next function, if you car operator must install in adjust something, is ink profiles. And a very important overview, the measuring devices. Here we have the inking. We can also switch over very easy to the measuring values. A complete new function offer we with direct start. Here the operator can select functions directly, start it, and we see in IntelliGuide how the process will be run up. Also very new is here you can go into adjustments directly in settings, in the programs. And if you want to get more information, with one click you get the right operation manual, for example, in this example about wash-up devices. Also new function is the overview about the press. Here we get, for example, the paper run or the current job. And if you want more adjustments to do at the delivery, with one click, you are in the air settings. And for example, here, again, we see the settings, the ink, the documentation. And here you get also a direct online help for the operator. Also completely new on this press center, we have now included the LED daylight lamp. And the beautiful thing is you can switch with one touch between D50 and D 65. And on top, if you go back, you can switch UV on and off. Remember, today it takes 30 minutes to change the lamps if you want to switch UV on or off. And clear, we can also switch on and off the lamp. Also included here, the overview about consumables. If you must change something or prepare the job for the next job, here you get an overview. And if you go to a printing unit again, you get all details in one overview. If we go back to the summary, here what you see is a new Speedmaster operating system, and we call it the Heidelberg User Experience on the Speedmaster.
So that gave a quick impression on what we have done and what we have implemented. A lot of interesting features and details, but we as well are confronted with the situation that many print shop owners ask us. We do not have only very skilled operators. We have good ones. We have experts, and we have not so good ones, not so skilled ones. And can we not adapt the functionalities according to the skill level of the operators? And that's exactly what we are doing with a function that's called a smart setup. We can block for the operator level some functions. For example, it makes no sense to change characteristic curves if you have no idea what you are doing here, and therefore we can block this, and only the expert is able to utilize those. You can then develop your people and train them. We have some training, some interesting training parts now in our Heidelberg Assistant, and we of course are offering on-premise trainings as well for your staff. Well, present the mobile app is the next feature we have. We discussed it's nice that we have all the information on the wall screen and that we bring with IntelliLine everything to the printing unit. But if the helper is going and collecting all the stuff which he needs for the next job, he would love to have on a smartphone all the information required. And therefore, we developed this kind of app. And here again, Jürgen Mittmann has some details of our real-time wall screen app.
And here we show you the next highlight to the Trooper, the Press Center Mobile, our mobile user interface for the helper on a tablet. You can see on real time what is the machine doing. For example, here the XL75, it rises up the speed to 15,000. We get a status information which job is running, which with speed we get. But the other highlight is we have the queue on my tablet. Here you see we have three jobs in the queue. We can select every job, and the helper has the chance to look into the job change overview to see that he must prepare, for example, for the next job, the Pantone colors.
So, but now let's move to another highlight called Plate to Unit, our brand new plate logistic system on the printing machine. Why are we doing this? We are asked by more and more customers. We want to go for shorter and shorter runs, even down to 100 sheets per job. And we want to have offset quality, offset consistency, and offset cost there. And we need to adapt the workflows here. And if you do 10 jobs or even 20 jobs per hour, it's nearly impossible to provide all the plates and dispose the plates in due time. And to find a person who wants to do that over an 8-hour shift, not only for one day, but for months. And therefore, it's very clear that we have to solve this problem with a fully automatic system. As you can see here, just in a partly automation, all plates are moved in automatically. You just move in on this elevator on the feeder. You move in the trolley, which is required by the press center. Then you have the right plates for the next 10 jobs. And these are all provided completely autonomously via push to stop. At the end, this is only 50% of the truth. This is the mechanical part. The other 50% is the integration, the software integration. how do I steer my production? How do I make sure that I have the right plates on the right trolley? How do I track this and all this kind of stuff? This is the other part which we provide via our Prinect production workflow as well. We can reduce the 23 touch points we normally use in a conventional CTP to press plate logistic line down to 3 touch points only. And I think that is a big progress, and that's the prerequisite for short run industrialized production. When we are sending out our technicians to solve the one or other problem at your premises, we found out that 80% of all service interventions that we have when it comes to inking problems are related to incorrect roller settings, especially in the dampening unit. We are talking about an ink water balance, and a balance is always needs to be controlled very seriously. And talking about peak performance, it makes most sense to automate that as much as we can, to give you the opportunity to reproduce your results, your productivity in a high productive environment. This is a must. And therefore, we are proud to introduce the first fully remote controlled dampening system. We call it HiColor Pro. You can not only increase the speed as we could before as well, you can modify the pressure of the metering and dampening roller, and we have a clear display how the shrinking of the rollers is set. What is the advantage? I'll show you on an example. You have here the plate, and you have the metering roller and the pen roller, and every printer knows it. Over time, you will have a tone on one side only. So when you're in this situation today, what are you doing? You're increasing the speed. Yeah, you're giving just more water. That solves your problem. But on the other side, you have too much water on the rest of the plate. Yeah, and that can cause problems. It can lead to emulsification, color variations, streak marking, ghosting, even drying problems can occur, or it can influence the color control system. So for special applications, for UV, for all applications where the window of the ink water balance is narrow, this is maybe not a good idea. So we're doing better with HiColor Pro. We of course have the same problem, yeah? Single side toning, the machine is getting warm, and maybe we need a little bit more water on just one side. And therefore, we can now very convenient give a little bit more water, very tiny, on the side which is affected, and therefore getting rid of the problem without having too much water on the rest of the plate. We have that in beta test for a few months now, and I can tell you all the printers who are dealing with that really love this function, and I'm pretty sure when you talk about that with your printers, they will love it as well. Another function that we have is Roller Check Assistant. We have that for quite some time. We have increased the functionality now that we have the dampening rollers here as well. You push a button and the machine produces a sheet with all the nips of the rollers where you can measure them, and you can keep your productivity or your quality up on a certain level for reproducibility and high performance 24/7, 365 days a year. Waste management is more and more important, especially in the packaging area. We have a lot of situations where the print buyers are auditing their suppliers. And I think whoever has done an audit with a pharmaceutical print buyer knows what I'm talking about. We have some nice features that make your life easier here, because we have a trackable closed loop waste management here. We have the CodeStar. It's an inkjet device on the feeder applying a sheet ID. And we have the inspection control 3 able to read this sheet ID and to identify this is a good sheet or it's a waste sheet. So for each individual sheet, for each sheet number. Now we can extract the sheet directly in our waste extractor, or we can put it on the delivery pile, insert a strip, or have a different action there. We have a function called device assistant where we can configure what should be the reaction of the press for which kind of fault. So very unique and very individually configurable for your needs. There are a lot of other things coming up. I'm not able to really go into detail with everyone, since otherwise we were sitting here the next 2 hours. But a few things maybe just mentioned. Yeah, we will come up with the next generation of impress control. Our spectrophotometric inline measurement will deliver now, after 30 sheets already, the first fully measured sheet. 20% lower high weight of our blanket is something that helps your operator in his daily life. We will accelerate the plate changing time of the Autoplate XL3 by 35%. We will have for the coating unit now an impression, automatic impression cylinder washup that saves up to 50 hours per year. We can print up to 1.8 millimeters stock. Cardboard. We have the Foilstar Cure, a new reel path of the Foilstar code foil application, where we apply code foil on foil material, in-mode label foil, for example, but as well can use that for holographic effects. Casting cure effects are possible with that one. We have improved our auto non-stop system. We could increase the maximum speed for aqueous coating on both sides in one pass, LPL configurations, to 18,000 sheets per hour, very unique and for longer runs quite important. The XL75 was completely redesigned with a new ergonomic gallery concept, which we have from the XL106. Comes with 16,500 speed now as a standard for the straight machines, and of course as well all the intelligent assistants I mentioned. Push to stop end to end, before I finalize here, is the next level. I just want to summarize what we can do here. We come from the scheduler, we bring it to the CTP, the right plates in the right sequence. We indicate, we know exactly on which trolley are which plates. That's known by the PrintAct software, by the workflow. We bring this to the machine. There's no touch to load the plates to get them out. We have a waste-free pile that we deliver to the post press. And here we will have push to stop functionality, which my colleague Stefan Detke will now introduce to you as well. Before we do so, it's time for me to say thank you for your attention for the sheet fit part here. And think about the yellow bar. Find out how big the yellow bar is in your print shop. And we love to discuss that with you at Drupa or at any other time. And just in order to get the excitement a little bit across, and as you cannot be here, we took the camera and took a few impressions about our brand new XL75 in our PMC. And that's what we're going to see now before Stefan Detke is entering the stage for the exciting post-press push-to-stop innovations. Thank you.